بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم and welcome to the APSEX online support program weekly video lesson. I am Madiha Kamal from Senior Girls Wing. This lecture will help the students of grade 8 to solve their assignment for week number 6. The basic objective behind this lecture is that the students will be able to understand the basic definition of set, concept related to the description of set, equal sets and empty set. While the success criteria is that the students must clearly understand the meaning of distinct and well-defined. It should be kept in mind that no element in a set can be repeated. Recap. You have already learned about the set of numbers in grade 7, like the set of integers, set of whole numbers, set of natural numbers, set of even numbers, set of odd numbers, and many other sets. But a question can arise in your mind that why these numbers enclosed within the brackets are known as set and how they can be made. So the basic purpose behind today's presentation is that you will be able to understand the definition of set and you can easily describe a set after this presentation. Concepts to be discussed are taken from chapter number 14, Introduction to Set Notation. And the basic definition of a set will be explained in the lesson. Then I will tell you how you can describe a set and when two sets are said to be equal and when a set is said to be an empty set. Definition of a set. Set is the collection of well-defined and distinct objects. Well-defined means that while writing the members of the set, there will be no personal judgment that will be involved. And distinct objects mean that each member has a separate identity. For example, pile of books, bunch of keys, team of players, and school of dolphins. In all these examples, the members of the set are distinct because each member has a separate identity and all the members are well defined because these members are not based on the personal judgments. Presentation of a set. By convention, we use capital letters to denote a set. For example, capital H. We use small letters to denote elements in a set. For example, small h. Sometimes the elements can be in capital letters. For example, if there is a set of girls in the class getting more than 90% marks and you are asked to list all the members or the elements of a set in set notation, then this will be your answer. Here, capital H is the set of hardworking girls in the class. G1, G2, G3, G4 are the elements of set H. So, G1 is an element or the member of H. G6 is not an element of H. So, we can write that G6 is not an element or member of H. There are four elements in H, G1, G2, G3 and G4. So, number of elements in set H is equal to 4. Well-defined and distinct objects. There are two very important concepts to understand if we want to understand the definition of set. For this, I will explain these two concepts by the help of example. The first example is of distinct. If K is the set of letters in the word rhythm, how should we list the elements? Is the letter H distinct? The letter H is not distinct in the word rhythm because this letter is used twice to form the word. So while writing down the set, we will not write H again because each element of the set must be distinct. Example of well-defined. A movie well liked by my classmates. If this is a set, state whether it is a well-defined set? No, because a book may be liked by some but not others. But while writing down a well-defined set, you must have to ignore the personal likings or dislikings. Now the students can easily solve the practice now to part A on page number 395 and exercise 14A question number 5D and E parts. Two more concepts to learn are of finite set, set containing finite number of elements, for example 2, 4, 6, 8, while infinite set, set containing infinite number of elements 2, 4, 6, 8 and so on. So, while keeping in view all the previous concepts which we have discussed in the slides, you can now easily solve these questions of the exercise. Exercise 14A, question number 1, AB part, question number 4, C part, question number 9, question number 10, B part, practice now on page number 393. All these questions are from your assignment which are given to you. Describing of a set. There are few ways to describe a set. The first way is describing a set in words. For example, B is the set of odd positive integers less than 11. While the second way is to list all the elements in a set in set notation. For example, B is equal to 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. While the third way is to describe the elements in a set in set notation. For example, B is equal to X such that X is an odd positive integer less than 11. Describing a set in words. For example, if a question is given to you in set builder notation form, like if there is a set G and the elements of the set are 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 22 and 24 and you are asked to describe the set in words, then the answer will be G is the set of even numbers between 10 and 26. Now, if there is another question in which a set is described in words in the set notation form and you are asked to describe the set in words, like O is a set X such that X is the first 5 consonants of the English alphabets and you are asked to describe the set in words, then the answer will be O is the set of first 5 consonants of the English alphabet. You can solve exercise 14A question number 11 part A and B from your assignment by the help of this description. The second way of describing a set is listing all the elements in a set in set notation form. For example, if in a question a set is described in words like D is the set of perfect squares between 10 and 20 and you are asked to list all the elements in set notation form, then your answer will be D is a set having element 16. As 16 is the perfect square of 4 and there is no other number between 10 and 20 that can be a perfect square of any other number. Now, another question. If a set is described in the set notation form, like Q is equal to X such that X is a positive integer between 1 and 10 exclusive, and you are asked to list all the elements in set notation form, then your answer will be Q is such a set that is equal to the elements 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 1 and 10 will not be included in this set because the word exclusive is used. If the word inclusive was used, then 1 and 10 will also be the part of this set. Now from your exercise 14A, you can solve question number 10, A and B part, question number 13, first part by using these concepts. The third way of describing a set is describing the elements in set notation form. Like for example, if set notation form is given, V is equal to having the elements minus 8, minus 4, 0, 4, 8 and 12. And you are asked to describe the elements in set notation form, then your answer will be V is equal to X such that x is a multiple of 4 between minus 8 and 12 inclusive. Inclusive means that minus 8 and 12 will also be a part of this set. Now, in another question, if a set is described in words like D is the set of even prime numbers and you are asked to describe the elements in set notation form, then your answer will be D is equal to X such that X is an even prime number. Concept of equal sets. Definition. Two sets A and B will be said to be equal if number of elements of A is equal to number of elements of the set B, and the second is that all the elements of the set A will be equal to all the elements of the set B. By convention, we should list the elements in ascending order for numbers and in alphabetical order for letters. But the order of the elements of both sets can still be different. For example, in a question, if there is a set A that is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 and there is a set B in which the members are 1, 4, 2, 3, are both sets equal? As the number of elements of set A is 4, number of elements of set B is also 4 and all the elements of A are equal to the number of elements of the set B. So answer will be that both sets are equal, although the elements are not in the same order. From the exercise, you can solve practice now number 3 by using this concept. Empty set. Definition. Set with no element is an empty set. It is represented with the symbol, which is pronounced as phi. In other words, such a set is also called a null set. For example, if in a question the set is described in the set notation form like A is equal to X such that X is the day of the week starting with Z. Now you are asked to list all the elements of a set in set notation. Its answer will be a phi set because there is no day of the week that starts with Z. So A is equal to phi or A is equal to a null set. A is equal to phi. If phi is written inside the brackets, then it is not an empty set. It contains one member, that is phi. So if you want to write phi, you have to write phi without using brackets. From your exercise, you can easily solve question number 13, second part, question number 7, A and B part with the help of these concepts. I think you can easily solve the problems related to these concepts. If still you are facing any problem related to these concepts, then please ask your maths teacher. Thank you.